Hi, I'm Andy Catsall, and I'm going to explain how to draw a city rhino as seen at Chelsea and Westminster Hospital. First of all, start by drawing the rhino shape. I put in the background first. It's important to draw it quite big on the paper so that you can fit in all the details later. Sketch in the stomach shape, and then the back leg. Now sketch in the front leg. Shoulder. And the curves that make up the head. Now to add the ears, like leaf shapes, and the triangle shapes for the horns. Now sketch in a line for the ground level and make sure foreground feet touch this and that the head doesn't drop below. Draw in a line for the background feet also, and put the back leg in, and draw the tail. So there we have the outline shape of the rhino. Rub out any unwanted lines and refine the drawing, make it a little bit neater. I put in a few lines to show the curve of the ribs here. Now that the rhino is done, it's time to start thinking of which buildings to make it out of. These are the sketches I made of the buildings I put into my rhino. From my sketches, I then work out which buildings would work best and fit and where. For example, spiky buildings for horns. Okay, so I think that the Albert Hall is a good round shape for the back leg. It's a matter of breaking everything down into 3D shapes that fit into the creature. Now it's time to add the hospital on the front shoulder. It's a rectangular box shape if you draw it from above. I'm drawing this building in curve to follow the shape of the stomach. I often bend the shape of buildings to fit the animals. And I'm going to add in some trees along the bottom here. I often find trees are good to put in and fill up spaces. For the longest horn, the Albert Memorial is a good fit, as it's nice and pointy, like the horn on the rhino. And I'm going to put the Natural History Museum here, and the entranceway will make up the eye. And down here is a tree for the nose. So more of the Natural History Museum, the roof's making up the ears. And I'm going to put some more trees in here, that's the back of the jaw. Now we have the rough outlines of all the objects making up the rhino. So erase some of the unnecessary lines again, so cleaning it up and redrawing in more detail. More detail added to the basic shapes of the Natural History Museum, taking out some unnecessary lines. Adding in some columns. Adding some windows. And the steps beneath the doorway, or the eye as it is on our rhino. So So you can keep adding details until you have a pencil drawing, something like this, lots of windows and other bits on it. This can then be worked up again into a more finished and refined ink drawing. Or even further still, into a coloured version like this. You really can go as far as you like, go wild.